Thank you very much. Good morning, and good morning to everybody out there. It's fantastic to be here. It's great to be here in Glasgow with you people, and it's great to have it all broadcast to so many thousands of other people all across the place. Just a wonderful thing. I do lots of events, but I've never done an event quite like this before. So thanks to Scottish Brookes Trust and the BBC. I'll do a few things this morning. I'll talk a bit about myself, about where I came from. I'll talk about my writing. I'll show how I turn my kind of thoughts into books, how a book comes into the world. I'll answer your questions. I'll read a bit to you. And it'll be lots of stuff just about reading, but also about writing. One of the things I really love about writing for young people is that the people I write for are all writers, because you all have to write, don't you? Everybody out there has to write. Everybody watching has to write. People say to writers, when did you start writing? But the question should be, for people who aren't writers, when did you stop writing? So people grew up as writers. So what I want you to do, first of all, is to do something which seems very weird, but is also very ordinary. So here I'm standing in front of you as a grown man. I want you to imagine me getting younger and younger and younger and younger. Till I'm a boy, till I'm a little toddler, and I'm getting smaller and smaller. Can you imagine that? And weirdly, you can't you? I say, there's an empty space. Can you imagine a young David Almond in it? And you can. And imagine David Almond getting younger and younger until he's just a baby. Can you imagine a baby in that space? You can't you? It's weird. There's an empty space. Imagine David Almond as a baby. I think I began to be a writer when I was a baby, a time I can't even remember. When I was a baby, just a few months old, my mum said she used to put me in her arms and walk down the high street in Felling, which is the town I grew up in. So I grew up in a little town called Felling, across this river from Newcastle, and halfway down the hill, on the high street, there was a sign above the street which said Almond Printer. And my Uncle Amos had a printing shop. My mum used to take me along the alleyway to see my Uncle Amos, go into the printing shop, and she said one day she was standing there in the printing shop with little David in her arms. Can you imagine him? He's quite cute, isn't he? There I was in her arms, and she said, we're standing there one day. She was talking back and forward to my Uncle Amos. And as we stood there, the printing machine started to work and turn. And off the bottom of the printing machines came the printed pages of the local newspaper. And she said, at that moment, little David Almond started to jump up and down and go, goo goo ga 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 ga, pointing and laughing at the printed pages coming off the rollers. And you know the way babies' eyes are caught by flickering lights or by birds flying overhead? My eyes were caught by print. And I went, goo. And I fell in love with it. And one of the things that I still love more than anything about being a writer is just that. Black print on white paper, I think, is absolutely gorgeous. And probably that began when I was the baby, when I looked at print and went, oh. And of course, you couldn't go to that baby and say, what do you want to be, son, when you grow up? I want to be a writer. Of course, you couldn't. But I think the image of print got into my brain. And ever since, I've been pursuing it. Ever since, I've been trying to make that. And every time one of my, excuse me, every time one of my books comes out, it's sent to me by the publishers, and I think, I feel very clever. Oh, yes, I'm very clever, very grown up. But inside me still, there's a little baby just a few months old going, goo goo ga 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 ga. So I began to be a writer when I was a baby.